Boston buzzed with ball shooting robots this past weekend as hundreds of high school students competed in the First Robotics Competition. Teams designed, built, and controlled robots for each two-minute round.
Yeah, so this is part of an international program called First Robotics Competition. It's a competition for high school students. They have 6 weeks to build a robot to play a particular game. The game this year is a little bit like basketball. The robots have to be able to shoot basketballs through hoops, and then at the end they have to balance on a bridge, and then they get points for doing that in various ways.
This competition hosted teams from all over the world, including Canada, Turkey, and Mexico, all fighting for the chance to move on to the championships. To earn first place, teams must go through a rigorous judging process.
The judging, there's actually kind of two ways to win here. The first way is this sort of straightforward, you know, the robots compete and somebody gets the most points and they win. But we also have judges going around and interviewing each team. So they interview for attributes about the robot, like who has the coolest control system, who has the neatest mechanism, who has the best industrial design and reliability, it's how well a team represents the ideals of FIRST. Are you inspiring others? Are you getting other teams involved? Are you mentoring other teams? How are you spreading FIRST and excitement about STEM fields into your community?
But before each team can release their robots onto the field, they must meet a number of design requirements, including weight and dimension limitations. In such a short period of time, competitors are under pressure to use their time wisely.
We're preparing before the season even starts. We're preparing at the beginning of our school year, getting our team together, getting things organized and everything.
It takes a lot of time and effort. Over the 6 weeks, you know, it's a pretty short period to build a full robot. So it's all about, you know, delegating the work between our team and working together to make something that will work and do its part when we get to the competition.
We were overweight last competition, so we had to like drill holes and like make things smaller and use less material, so we would be underweight.
But all this hard work pays off. Starting as young as 14, these students are learning more than just how to build a functioning robot. They're gaining basic engineering skills that will prepare them for life after high school.
Since I'm a freshman, I was taught like the basics of robotics, like how different motors work, how two motors can interact with each other to make a robot faster or stronger.
FIRST is actually a really good microcosm of the engineering development process. It's a really good program that teaches people that there's more to this than just building the best robot with the best arm mechanism or best drivetrain, that there is something to engineering that's beyond that.
Win or lose, at the end of the day, the students are happy just to be competing.
I go out there and I'm thinking we're going to do awesome because we really work hard at it and we're really proud of what we come up with.
Kirsten Taggart, IDG News Service.